covering large areas. And then this is the sifter when you want to blend or add highlighting or low lights. It works really well. So I typically mix in this really pretty walnut brown with the black to kind of gray it out on the edges. And make a nice transition. Spoon and finish off on that side. Then we're going to start with our darkest red and kind of work up forming petals with the spoon. So you work the spoon kind of a roundish shape. Another one. And another petal in the center, not worrying if it all looks like it's running together because it'll be shaded out in a minute. Okay. Then you do your shading. Nice, pretty medium red for that. You just add a little bit of shading here and there. We work up a lighter shade. to make it a poinsettia. And then to add the white, the background. You do the same. The white ones, a little more difficult. Oh, I missed one. Because there isn't really any shades for the white. And the white poinsettia tends to have some yellowy green in the actual petals. So we have to add in some yellow on top of the white. And it's okay if you get a little too much, because you can add more white on top. And then I use a nice fern green with white, so it's already toned down a little bit, and add in a little bit of green. And it's a transparent, so it'll go nicely. And then I use an almond color to add in some shading. And it's not that much different than the white, so you really have to kind of pack it in. You'll go back to your walnut to add in some detailing for this one. Let me add in some leaves. I'll use my dark green. And I'm adding in a little adventuring green, which will make the leaves sparkle and it's a little waxy. Opaque green on one side. Which I know the fritz all look the same right now, but when it fires, it'll look completely different. And voila, poinsettias.